Yesterday in the Irish Sunday Independent magazine, there was a really nice puff piece where six Scientologists answer basic questions about Scientology. And according to the reporter, the answers were published exactly as they said. So I thought I'd like to do something very similar and answer the same questions. The first one is, how did you become a Scientologist? Well, quite simply, my brother was involved first, and then my ex-wife got involved. So when I came along to collect my wife one day, and I was asked to do a free personality test, everyone was really friendly and nice. It was almost like a family affair, or let's say that the threat or the warning signs were easy to dismiss, as my family were already involved. A lot of families get involved like this. What has Scientology done for you? In retrospect, it's done nothing. At the time I was involved, I did believe that I was becoming more intelligent, happier, freer, less worry, no problems. You know, I could rattle off the list until I'm describing a perfect human being. The problem is, that only applies when you're in Scientology, and when you leave and start to analyze what you've gone through, it's intangible, it's bullshit, it can't be proved. Sorry, guys. Are you more prosperous, intelligent, successful as a result of Scientology? Well, let's just take prosperous. I'd have to say no, because myself and every Scientologist I ever knew was constantly short of money, except for the millionaire ones, of course. But the ones who were doing really well in life tended to be doing well before Scientology, so it was kind of easy for them. So prosperous, no. Intelligent? According to Scientology's IQ tests, yes, but I was given the same test over and over again, so really, I got to know it pretty well, and I kind of got to work out which answers were right and which answers were wrong. They apparently have two that they use, but I only ever got one. Successful? I don't consider myself a failure, but I wouldn't put that down to Scientology, as I've not been doing it for the last 17 years. Are those people who say bad things about Scientology lying? No. The information that people who say bad things, that information comes from documented evidence. For example, L. Ron Hubbard's war record. That's just one example, where he claims to have been injured. He wasn't. He claims to have won medals. He didn't. He claims to have been active in this field, that field. He wasn't. Why is there so much criticism of Scientology and indeed Scientologists? Speaking for myself and the Irish Anons that I protest with, we don't criticize Scientologists. They're free to believe what they want to believe. We're simply protesting the abuses of this organization. That's why there's criticism of Scientology. There's been deaths that have been covered up. There's been child abuse that's been covered up. There's been fraudulent goings on financially that have been covered up. Basically, you know, if you're a critic of Scientology, Hubbard says that you've got crimes. What I'm starting to find out is that Scientologists have crimes. Oh, yes. Is Scientology a cult? I'm going to say yes, but in actual fact, there's a cult within a cult in Scientology, and that's the C organization. That's when you really get down to, you know, the cult. The public face of Scientology, the Class 5 organizations and the missions and groups and self-betterment groups, don't really qualify as cultish. However, if you take the definition of what a cult does, and quite simply, it controls your thoughts, emotions, behavior, and information, then yes, indeed, Scientology is a cult. All of it. what do you believe as a Scientologist? What are your beliefs around this world and the next? Well, the pat answer was always that I'm an immortal spiritual being with unlimited potential, which quite simply means that you've been around forever and you will continue to be around forever. And that's quite a powerful thing to believe in, because it puts you head and shoulders above everyone who doesn't believe in that. Do you have any children? Are they Scientologists? I have 6 children, and they're not Scientologists. How young can you become a Scientologist? This is interesting. People on the boat were aged 4, 11, you know, all kinds of ages. One girl in particular was on the boat with Hubbard and a father, and the father got posted somewhere else. The girl was left on the boat for a year asking to be reunited with her father. I've seen children in Ireland, in Scientology, in Dublin, who were left unsupervised, were on a first floor with the window open, with nothing between the child and the footpath below. If she'd slipped or something, she was dead. Not an adult in sight. Now, that's just a small thing that I've witnessed, but other exes that I know are also concerned about the way Scientologists treat their children. It's worrying. Babies have died in Australia. The daughter of one of Scientology's top lawyers had an awful death when she was electrocuted. I don't really want to go on too much about that, because I'll just be accused of, like, you know, talking about the bad stuff. So, how does Scientology differ from other religions? It differs quite simply because it charges for its services. There's only one free course in Scientology, and that's a course that teaches you how to sell Scientology to your friends and family and other people. So that tells you something. You can spend up to, they reckon, or it has been estimated and calculated, at between 380 and 500,000 to achieve all that's available in Scientology. So tops 500,000, shall we say. Some people have spent an awful lot more. Have you ever given money to Scientology? I have. I also had to fund myself when I was working on staff for literally sometimes no pay whatsoever. So that money had to come from somewhere. I'd say I'm definitely out of pocket because of my experience with Scientology. Why is Scientology so popular in Hollywood, such as John Travolta, Tom Cruise? I really don't know. I'd think you would need to ask them. What is the one thing about Scientology you feel that people would be surprised to learn? I think people would be surprised if it turned out to be true, because obviously it isn't. If the lies that are used as bait in the trap actually turned out to be true, if they worked, you know, but they don't. Interestingly, Scientologists claim to use the tech every day of their lives. However, when asked, they can't say how. The closest I ever got to someone saying how they use the tech, they said they used a locational process on the child when they woke up after having had a nightmare. Basically what they did was just talk to them and comfort them. So that doesn't wash. One of the big things about the whole subject is it claims to be scientific, but it fails to stand up to any kind of scrutiny whatsoever. All the gains and wins are personal and very subjective. No one has ever measured the successes of a Scientologist. They say all kinds of things, yet none of it is demonstrably provable. So it's all happening up here, you know? That's answered all the questions anyway. Thank you.